Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
So we're going to read Bhagavad Gita, Chapter 4, Transcendental Knowledge, Text Number 18.
今天我们要学习的是 《国家梵歌原意》第四章的第十八节诗。
Karmani akarmaya pasyet.
Karmani akarmaya prasyet.
Akarmani chakarmaya.
Akarmani chakarmaya.
Sabhudi man manusheshu.
Sabhudi man manusheshu.
Sayukta Krishna karma krit.
Sayukta Krishna karma krit.
Karmani akarmaya pasyet.
Karmanya karmaya prasyet.
Akarmani cha karmaya.
Akarmani cha karmaya.
Sabhudhi man manusheshu.
Sabhudhi man manusheshu.
Sayukta Krishna karma krit.
Sayukta Krishna karma krit.
Karmanya karmaya pasyet.
Karmanya karmaya prasyet.
Akarmani chakarmaya.
Akarmani chakarmaya.
Sabhudi man manusheshu.
Sabhudi man manusheshu.
Sayukta Krishna karma krit.
Sayukta Krishna karma krit.
Okay, word meaning, karmani in action.
Karmani 在活动中.
Akarma in action.
Akarma 不活动.
Yeah, one who.
Yeah, 谁.
Pasyet observes.
Pasyet 观察到.
Akarmani in inaction.
Akarmani 在不活动中.
Cha also.
Cha 也.
Karma, fruit of action.
Karma, 果报性活动.
Ya, one who.
Ya, 谁.
Sa, he.
Sa, 他.
Buddhiman is intelligent.
Buddhiman, 聪明的.
Manusheshu, in human society.
Manusheshu, 在人类社会中.
Sa, he.
Sa, 他.
Yukta is in the transcendental. Is in the transcendental position.
处在超然的境界中.
Krishna karma krit, although engaged in all activities.
Krishna karma krit, 虽然从事各种活动.
Translation. One who sees in action, in action, and action in inaction is intelligent among men, and he is in the transcendental position, although engaged in all sorts of activities.
第四章的第十八节诗译文, 谁能在活动中看到不活动，在不活动中看到活动，谁就是明智的人。他虽然从事各种活动，但却处在超然的境界中。
Therefore, by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami, Srila Prabhupada,
a person... 由圣恩 A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada 所做的要旨
A person acting in Krishna consciousness is naturally free from the bonds of karma. His activities are all performed for Krishna. Therefore, he does not enjoy or suffer any of the effects of work.Consequently, he is intelligent in human society, even though he is engaged in all sorts of activities for Krishna. Akarma means without reaction to work. The impersonalist ceases fruitive activities out of fear, so that the resultant action.May not be a stumbling block on the path of self-realization. But the personalist knows rightly his position as the eternal servitor of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Therefore, he engages himself in the activities of Krishna consciousness. Because everything is done for Krishna,He enjoys only transcendental happiness in the discharge of this service. Those who are engaged in this process are known to be without desire for personal sense gratification. The sense of eternal servitorship to Krishna makes one immune to all sorts of reactionary elements of work.
要旨，怀着 Krishna 意识活动的人，自动摆脱业报的束缚。他所做的一切活动，全都是为了 Krishna。因此，他既不享受活动的结果，也不会为结果而受苦。尽管他在从事各种活动，但他是人类中的明智之人。因为他所做的一切都是为了 Krishna。梵文 Akarma 的意思是没有报应的活动。非人格神主义者因为害怕而停止了功利性活动，以免活动的报应成为自我觉悟路途上的障碍。但是人格神主义者却正确地认识到自己实际上是至尊人格守神的永恒仆人，因此从事与 Krishna 知觉意识有关的活动。由于他所做的一切都是为了 Krishna， 他在做服务时感受到的就只是超然的快乐。从事这种活动的人没有丝毫寻求感官享乐的欲望。永远为 Krishna 服务的意识知觉使人免除各种活动的报应。
Om Magyana Timarandasya Gyananjana Shalakaya Chatsur Militam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha.Vandeham Shri Guru Shri Yata Padakamalam Shri Gurun Vaishnavamstya Shri Rupam Saprajatam Sahagana Raghunatham Vitam Tam Sadevam Sadvaitam Savadutam Parijana Sahitam Krishna Chaitanya DevamShri Radha Krishna Padam Sahagana Lalita Shri Vishaka Nitamscha Hey Krishna Karana Sindhu Dinabandhu Jagatpate Gopesha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namostate Tapta Kanchana Gaurange Radhe Vrindavaneshwari Vrishabhanu Sute Devi Pranamami Hari Priye Vanchakaupatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Bhayevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Srivasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare. So in this chapter 4, Lord Krishna is explaining transcendental knowledge in relation to his own self. And in verse number 14, Lord Krishna had described that there is no work that affects him, and nor does he aspire for the fruits of any of the work.
So
hearing this, we may think that maybe this also applies to our own self. Maybe there's no work which affects us. We can do what we like and we won't be affected. But we should understand we're not on the same level as Lord Krishna. So then Lord Krishna goes on in text number 16 to explain about action and inaction.
在第16节时, Krishna 继续说, 告诉我们什么是活动,
and Lord Krishna explains that even intelligent people have difficulty to understand this.
Krishna 在这一节诗中说, 就连, 聪明的人也分不清什么是活动,
so text number 16, Lord Krishna speaks about two things. He speaks about action and inaction.
因此在第十六节诗中, Krishna 解释了什么是活动,什么是不活动。
And text 17, he explains that there's something else. In addition to action and inaction, there is also forbidden action.
那在第十七节诗中, Krishna 更加的解释什么是活动,什么是被禁止的活动,什么是不活动。
Yeah, forbidden action means acts which are against the scriptures.
被禁止的活动意味着是违反经典教导的这种活动。
Sometimes people say to us that, oh, where in the Bhagavad Gita does Krishna say that we shouldn't eat meat? Where in the Bhagavad Gita does Krishna say that we shouldn't take intoxication?
有些时候我们会遇到一些人问我们说, 在Krishna在博迦梵歌中, 在哪里有说到我们不能吃肉, 然后不能吸食那些麻醉自我的东西呢? 在哪里?
So here, in text number 17, Lord Krishna is mentioning that there are actions which are forbidden.
那在这一节诗,第十七节诗中,第四章的第十七节诗, Krishna 就说明了, 有一些活动是被禁止的，不应该去从事的。
Forbidden action means activities which go against the teaching of the scriptures.
被禁止的活动啊的意思是啊，就是那种违反经典的教导的这种活动。
And certainly in the scriptures, we do learn about the importance of practicing religious principles.
那毫无疑问的，我们在经典中确实学到了，就是遵循规范原则的重要性。
Religious principles include such things as truthfulness, mercy, cleanliness, austerity.
就是经典讲到就是宗教原则的重要性，比方说诚实，仁慈，苦行。还有解禁，这些都是宗教原则。
Of course, there are other qualities also, like being non-violent.
当然还有一些原则，比方说非暴力。
There are actually many qualities which are encouraged by the scriptures, and at the same time, there are also qualities which are discouraged.
所以根据这个经典呢，有些品质是经典所推崇的，鼓励的，有些是经典禁止我们去从事的活动。
So one may consider that I should do things which are encouraged in the scriptures. I should act according to the religious principles.
所以我们就想说，我们应该是要就是根据经典教导的这种宗教原则来活动，我们应该要从事经典鼓励我们去从事的活动。
So this may be in the category of what we would call karma, to perform activities for our own material benefit.
那这个就属于 karma 的范畴，这个 karma 的范畴就是说为了我们自己的利益而去从事的活动。
So the scriptures, the Vedas particularly, they do offer a number of ways in which we can increase our own material situation, improve our own material condition of life.
在韦达经典中有一些地方很多的方面都有提到说如何能够增加我们物质生存的这种条件，能够改善这个条件，然后让我们过得更好。
This is what is referred to as karma kanda activities, or the path of material prosperity, the path of fruitive activities, the path of material enjoyment.
这个是物质的感官享乐的道路，叫做 karma kanda， 我们把它翻译成是业报之部，也就是遵循这个方法，我们可以得到物质上我们想要得到的那种享乐的这种结果。
Now in the second chapter, Lord Krishna has spoken about this path to Arjuna.
在《薄伽梵歌》的第二章中 ，Krishna 有告诉 Arjuna 关于这个 karma kanda 这个。业报之部的这个道理。
Krishna told Arjuna that if he fights in the battle, and even if he loses in the battle, he will still go to heaven.
Krishna 告诉 Arjuna， 如果你能够参战的话，那么即便你战败了，你也能够上升到天堂星球。
So of course a devotee is not very anxious to go to heaven because that's just a place of material enjoyment.
当然奉献者不是很向往所谓天堂星球，因为天堂星球也只不过是一个短暂的一个物质的享乐之地。
But for those who are looking to enjoy the material world, they can follow the scriptures.And they can get that result. They can go to the higher planets and enjoy.
但是对于那些想要 追求物质享乐的人他们可以按照这个道路，这个 karma kanda 的道路去遵循这个经典里面的教导，他们可以得到他们所想要的，上升到高等的天堂星球去从事更加的物质，得到更多的物质享乐的这条道路。
We find in all the different religions of the world, we find that this is encouraged in the practice of the religious process.
我们看到这个世界上有很多的宗教，其实都在鼓励人们去走这样的道路，去追求物质感官享乐。
But in Srimad Bhagavatam, Srila Vyasadeva rejects this and calls this as cheating religion.
但是在圣典国家瓦坛中，施拉维亚萨德夫他是斥责这样的这种教导，说这样的宗教叫做欺骗的宗教。
Because they're going to the temple or the church or whatever the place of worship, and they're praying to the Almighty, to the Supreme Lord. They're praying to Him, and they're asking for material benediction.
那么人们呢走这样道路的人，他们会到庙里或者是到教堂，他们去崇拜他们所谓的主，向他的主祈祷祈求他的主能够赐给他就是这种物质的感官的享乐。
So they're praying to their deity or to the God in the temple or in the church, and they're telling him how much they love himBut at the same time, they're asking, please give me my desire.
对，人们到这个教堂或者是到庙里去找他的神，或者是向那个神像祈祷好像在表达的他的爱。可是问题是，怎么同时又会要求神给他满足他的这种私欲呢？
So this kind of religious process is not a genuine religious process. It's considered to be cheating religion.
所以这样的宗教程序不是正宗的宗教程序，这个叫做欺骗的宗教。
Now there's another method by which people practice religion, and that is by stopping all action.
那还有一种宗教的修炼方法程序呢，它是叫人停止一切的活动。
Just like we see people like to sit and meditate, and they will simply stop all activity.
比方说有一种打坐冥想的方式，就用这个打坐冥想方式，然后停止所有的一切外在的这种活动。
They should not see anyone or anything.
他们不应该，他们看到任何的人或事物。
And they should not speak anything or hear anything.
就是在打坐冥想的时候，不应该要说任何的话，也不应该听见任何的话。
In other words, they want to stop all the actions of the senses.
这个意思就是说，他们就是关闭所有的感官，让所有的感官都停止活动。
So this is what is described as inaction.
这个就是所谓的这边讲到的不活动的意思。
But Lord Krishna is saying here today, we're hearing that the result of this inaction is simply that we get action, that there's going to be reactions coming.
可是在我们今天学到的这节诗中讲到这种不活动其实它并没有办法让我们不招致所谓的业报反应，它只是不活动而已，但是并没有办法不招致业报反应。
And there's going to be some actions taking place.
因为他们所谓的不活动，其实一定会有一些，还是会有一些活动会进行的，会发生的。
Someone, the meditator may stop activities, but he cannot stop breathing. He still has to breathe.
比方说有人打坐冥想，你看他看起来好像处在这种冥想的状态，没有在活动，可是他并没有办法停止他的呼吸啊。
He still has to eat, he still has to sometimes sleep.
他还是必须要吃东西，他还是必须要睡眠。
He's going to move. He's not going to sit completely still forever. At some point, he's going to move.
他没有办法就这样不活动下去。他必须在某个时机点，他总是必须要做一些活动的，没有办法保持不活动的状态。
So he's trying to avoid action, but there are some activities which he cannot avoid.
他试图去避免一些活动，但是有一些活动他还是避免不了。
I had the experience one time when I was staying in India. I was with my godbrother, Mahavishnu Swami, and we were traveling in India and distributing Prabhupada's books.
我个人有一些经验在印度。有一次，我跟我的神兄弟 Mahavishnu Swami Maharaj 呢，我们跟他在印度旅行，派发师来帕布帕的书。
So we passed by the on the roadside. We could see there was a mountain, and in the middle of the mountain there was a cave.And it was clear that there was a temple there inside the cave.
那我们走着走着在印度旅行，我们看到了一座山，然后在山的中央，有一个洞穴。那我们可以清晰的看到，在这个洞穴中有一座庙宇。
So we decided, let's go over and see if anybody's in the cave. So we stopped the vehicle and we took some books with us, and we went up the mountain into the cave.
因此，我们就决定去看个究竟。我们就带着我们的书乘坐了这个交通的工具，然后就到了这座庙里去看看这个状况是怎么样。
And we got inside the cave, and we found there was a young man, not very old, with a beard.And he was staying in the cave.
那我们进去了这个洞穴，我们就看到了一个年轻人，他留着大胡子，他住在这个洞穴中。
So he, when he saw us, he held his hand in front of his mouth, and he waved his hand, indicating that he'd taken a vow not to speak.
那当我们看到这个年轻人的时候，他用手就在他的鼻子下面就这样挥动着，其实他是在告诉我们他现在正在执行就是禁语的这种誓言。
So although he wasn't going to speak, we spoke to him and we told himThat, you know, we're traveling around and we're distributing the Bhagavad Gita and we're members of an international society and we have centers around the world where we're preaching Krishna consciousness. And we showed him the book and he was very interested. And so he had a little board and he wrote on his board, how much is it?
然后就是这个人他不能说话嘛，因为他是他的戒律，他现在在执行的誓言不能说话，所以 Maharaj 就跟这个年轻人说，我们是来自于国际Krishna 知觉意识协会，我们在世界各地有很多地方都有庙宇有中心，那我们呢就是 来到各个地方旅行，来派发这个释迦牟尼的书籍。那我们想知道，这个你对这个这本《国家梵歌》有没有兴趣呀？啊，马拉就跟他推荐这本书，那结果他不能讲话，但是他就写在那个板子上。他问说这一本多少钱？他说一本多少钱
？So we told him how much the book was, and he gave us some money. He bought a book.
嗯，对，然后这个人他就知道了，就给了 Maharaj 他们一些钱，就买了这本书。
So although he was trying to avoid all kinds of action and activities in the material world, his mind was still active and could see, you know, within the mind there's still thoughts and desires and actions performed.
嗯，那这个人尽管他试图想让自己保持不活动的状态啊，但是他后来事实上也感觉无聊了嘛。马拉就刚才又说，然后他的心意还是很活跃的啊，他也有各种的念头、各种的欲望，他想从事各种的活动啊，所以他的心念是非常活跃的。
And so this is a case. This man who was taking the vow of silence, he was trying to practice inaction, but still there was action. So that he's the example of action in inaction.
那这个人呢，他尽管想办法要让自己保持静默，就是因为他要旅行，就是不活动的，就是静默静语啊，不活动的这种誓言。但是他还是没有办法不活动，还是没有办法保持完全的不活动，所以这就是我们看到的例子，就是在这节诗中讲到的，在不活动中看到活动，他的心是很活跃的，他并没有办法让自己一直保持这样的这种静默不活动。
On the other hand, a devotee.Who is engaged in activities on behalf of Krishna? He's performing all kinds of activities.
那相反的，奉献者呢，他就是为了要就是为 Krishna 做服务，他去从事的各种的活动。
The devotee goes out for chanting Hare Krishna, singing and dancing. The devotee.Sometimes he cooks for Krishna. The devotee sometimes he will distribute books on behalf of Krishna.
那奉献者会出去就是唱诵圣名载歌载舞，歌唱舞蹈。那奉献者会为 Krishna 烹煮这个食物，那也会代表 Krishna 去派发书籍。
So he's performing all kinds of activities, but they're all on behalf of Krishna. They're all part of his bhakti yoga or service to Krishna.
所以奉献者代表 Krishna 从事各种的活动，他从事的这个奉爱服务的各种项目的活动。
So because the devotees are acting on behalf of Krishna.There are no reactions to his activities. Just like I said at the beginning, for Lord Krishna, there's no work that affects him.
就像我们刚才在第十四节诗中说到的，奎师那说。没有，他不会受到任何一种活动的影响。
Lord Krishna is not affected by any kinds of karma.
Krishna 不会遭受任何种类的这个业报。
And similarly, a devotee of Krishna who is acting on behalf of Krishna does also not get any reactions to his work. He doesn't suffer any karma.
因此这个代表 Krishna 去活动的奉献者， 也同样的就像 Krishna 不会招致任何的业报的捆绑，这个代表 Krishna 的奉献者也不可能招致任何物质的这个法则业报的捆绑，不可能。
So this is the nature of devotional service. It is action, but there's no reactions.
这就是奉爱服务的本质，也就是说他虽然在活动，可是他其实是不会制造任何的 业力的反应，不会有任何的业报，所以叫做 akarma 不活动。
So the devotee is the example of a person who is in action, who performs in, who is actually inactive but performing many activities.
所以奉献者就是这样的人的一种代表，也就是说他在活动中，可是他其实是不活动，不会造致任何的业力。
So in the purport, Srila Prabhupada speaks about the impersonalist, how they're afraid of action, they're afraid of performing activities and being caught in the material world.
在要旨中，Srila Prabhupada说到了这些非人格神主义者，他们非常的害怕会因为活动的报应会阻碍了他的道路，所以他们就是停止了这些所谓的这种果报性活动。
But a devotee is not afraid to perform all kinds of activities on behalf of Krishna.
但是奉献者一点都不害怕因为他代表着 Krishna 从事各种各样的活动。
The impersonalist,their actions are only for their own benefit.
可是这些非人格神主义者，他们所从事的活动其实都是为了他们自己的利益。
They're trying to come to the level of liberation where they can be free of the modes of nature.
他们从事这些他们的目的是为了希望自己能够达到所谓的解脱的这种境界，能够免除物质自然三种属性的捆绑，这是非人格神主义者他们所向往的目标。
And so they make advancement very slowly and with great difficulty.
因此他们前进的道路既缓慢又困难。
But the devotee, by simply using his senses and his body and mind in the service of Krishna,very easily gets free of the modes of nature.
但是奉献者用他们的身口意来为 Krishna 做服务，他们却很轻易地超越了所有的物质的这种属性的捆绑。
The devotee, without even thinking about it, the devotee comes to the transcendental platform above the modes of nature.
奉献者连想都不去想会不会受到捆绑的问题，他们是那么自然而然的来到了这种超然的这种境界这种层次，而超越了所有，摆脱了所有的物质属性的捆绑。
But the impersonalists, they're always struggling, they're always afraid of the reactions of the material energy.
可是这些非人格神主义者，他们却那么害怕，那么苦苦的挣扎，他们非常的害怕自己会被这个物质属性所钳制会在路途上遭受这种障碍。
So we in the Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna explains, because the devotee has surrendered to Krishna, so they easily pass over the modes of material nature.
在国家梵歌中Krishna 说，因为这些奉献者们他们臣服于Krishna， 所以他们可以很轻易的超越这个物质自然三种属性的钳制捆绑。
Devihi esha gunamayi mama maya duradaya mameva ye prapadyante mayamiktam tarantite. Lord Krishna is explaining thatIt's very difficult to get free from the material energy, but one who surrenders to him can easily cross beyond it.
这是在《薄伽梵歌》的第七章的第14节，是啊 ，Krishna 说：“我这由物质、自然三种属性组成的神性能量，难以克服，难以跨越，但是皈依我的人却能轻易地跨越它。”
So Lord Krishna continues this description of the devotee in the next verse also, in text number 19, where he describes the reactions to work, that they're all burned up, just like the wood is burned in a fire.
那在下一节是第四章的第十九节诗中Krishna 说到了，他说这样的一个活动者的报应其实已经被完美的知识之火烧成灰烬了。这种烧成灰烬很像是森林的大火把这个木材给烧成了灰烬。
So devotees not worried about the reactions of work, they're all burned to ashes.
所以一个奉献者完全不担心自己会遭受这种业报的这种捆绑束缚，因为奉献者知道的所有的这些东西都已经被这个完美的知识之火给烧成灰烬了。
And that the fire is that perfect knowledge which the devotee has.
那这个所谓的这个火指的就是奉献者所拥有的这个完美的超然的知识。
What is that knowledge? That knowledge is simply knowing that everything belongs to Lord Krishna.
那这个所谓的知识指的是什么呢？就是知道所有的一切都属于 Krishna， 这是真正的知识。
Lord Krishna is the supreme proprietor, and we are simply tiny parts of Lord Krishna, and we have the relationship of being the servant, and he is our master.
那 Krishna 他是至尊的拥有者，那我们只是微不足道的他的所属的从属于 Krishna 的一个部分。那 Krishna 他是至尊的主人，我们是永恒是他的仆人这就是我们所说的知识。
Now hearing that we are the servant eternally, this may discourage one from the path of devotional service.
Sorry, Maharaj, can you say again?
When we hear that we are the eternal servant, we may feel, oh, then I don't want to be a devotee. I don't want to always be the servant.
当我们听到讲到说，哇，我们是 Krishna 永恒的仆人，有的人就吓到了。哦，那我不想要走在这条奉爱的道路了。我不想当什么永恒的仆人。
But we should understand that there is more pleasure in being the servant than in being the master.
就这点我们要了解的是，我们要了解，其实当 Krishna 的仆人所能够得到的快乐，比当主人所能得到的快乐要大得多了。
In the material world, to be the servant is not very nice. But in the spiritual world,to be the servant is the greatest pleasure.
在物质世界呢，所谓的当这个仆人呢，可不是什么好事。可是，在灵性的领域中，当仆人却是最大的快乐。
So Lord Krishna wants to encourage all of us.In this process of devotional service.
So Krishna 要鼓励我们所有的人走在这个奉爱的道路上，从事奉爱服务。
We have to hear, we have to understand properly who we are, that we're not the body, we're all spirit souls.
我们必须要好好的聆听，并且很恰当的去了解认知这个知识，我们是灵性永恒的灵性的灵魂，我们不是这个物质躯体。
then we have to go on and understand the relationship of that spirit soul with the Supreme Soul.
而且我们必须更进一步的去认识到我们这个微小的这个这个我们是微小的灵性的灵魂，那么我们跟 Krishna 的这个关系是什么呢？
And we have to understand the importance of activity, proper action.
那我们也要进一步的去了解什么是叫做正确的活动是什么，要怎么样去活动，这是很重要的。
Sometimes people are attracted to the inaction. They think to stop activities, this must be very nice, very peaceful. I can stop, I don't do anything. But this is a very unnatural condition.
有的人会觉得，那个不活动应该是很棒的事，可能会让我们不活动，会让我们很平静，所以就不要活动吧。这样子的话，我就能够享受这个不活动带来的这种结果，不保持这种平静。他不想从事任何活动。
Some people will spend a lot of money just to occupy a room or a building somewhere where no one will disturb them and where they can be perfectly alone and quiet. And they'll pay a lot of money just to have that place. They will go and stay there.But they only stay for the weekend. After the weekend, then they go back to work.
有的人就有这样的倾向，他可以花大笔的钱去买了一栋大楼，或者是一个大的这个房子。那他就是打算就是在周末有时间的时候，他就独自在那里享受一个人的那种宁静。他们以为这样子可以得到，就是。在这种得到一种平静不活动的那种带来的这种享受。
But they won't stay there for very long. They can only stay there for a short time. After a few days, then okay, I want to go now. I have to go now. They won't stay there forever. No one wants to stay forever in that condition.
但是事实上，这样的状况根本就是不自然的。这根本不自然，违反灵魂的本性。有谁能够在这种独处的状态下，享受所谓的这个片刻的宁静，然后能够永恒的一直继续的享受下去呢？这不可能的，没有人能够继续处在这种状态中。
So impersonal liberation is like that. One may achieve impersonal liberation, come to the level of Brahman.But without proper activity, one will go back to the material world.
其实这种非人格神主义的解脱就是这种情况。如果没有非人格神主义的这种状态，如果没有从事继续再从事一些适当的活动的话，他们肯定会从他们所处的这种解脱的状态再跌下来，再回到了物质世界的存在中。
So we want devotees to understand how fortunate that we are that we have engagement in the service of Lord Krishna, and we can be engaged eternally in the service of Krishna.
所以我们奉献者实在是太幸运了，因为我们在从事对 Krishna 的这个奉爱服务，所以我们可以。永恒的一直做下去，一直从事这样的喜悦的这种奉爱服务。
And the nature of that devotional service is that it's very satisfying, and we want it more and more. The more we do service, the more we want service.
那这个奉爱服务的本质它就是让人能够感受到充分的满足。所以当我们从事更多的奉爱服务，我们就想要更多更多。
So we hope you're all experiencing that kind of taste in your devotional service.
我希望奉献者们都有在你们的奉爱服务中有品尝到这样的滋味，这种满足的这种滋味。
I was so happy to see the beautiful pictures of the devotees in Taichung doing Harinam Sankirtan.
我有看到台中的奉献者在Harinam 在 Sankirtan 的时候的那些相片。
And I saw also some just not long ago you had a festival of India and the devotees were there chanting and distributing books.
那在不久之前还有看到就是还有这个节庆印度就是台北的那个节庆，然后看到有很多的印度人，然后奉献者们在那边办活动，派发书籍。
So it's very nice that Krishna consciousness is going on so well there in Taiwan, and I'm very thankful to all of you for your efforts in this matter.
所以真的很感谢台湾的奉献者们，大家致力的在推广 Krishna 知觉意识运动。很感谢所有奉献者所付出的一切努力，做得非常好。
Okay, are there any questions?
那奉献者们有没有什么问题可以提出来？Hare Krishna, 奉献者们，大家可以趁这个时间来提问，可以打开麦克风，或者是在聊天室中写出来都可以。
Hare Krishna Maharaj.
Hare Krishna.
It says in the Prabhupada that because everything is done for Krishna, he enjoys only transcendental happiness in the discharge of this service. So my question is that we try to do everything for Krishna, but we still don't feel that happiness.
Krishna Baba Namakati 的问题是说，在今天的这节诗中，调子里，Srila Prabhupada 说到，由于这个奉献者所做的一切都是为了 Krishna， 他在做服务的时候感受到的就只是超然的快乐。那他想知道，可是奉献者确实从事了这些服务啊，就是为 Krishna 而从事这些活动，但是并没有感受到超然的快乐。
Well, I think we have to understand how devotional service can be influenced by the modes of nature.
我们必须要了解这个奉爱服务它是如何被物质自然属性所影响。
In the sentence which you refer to, Prabhupada said, "Everything is done for Krishna." So if we're actually doing the service for Krishna,then we will experience transcendental pleasure.
在要旨中，Srila Prabhupada 他说到的，所做的一切都是为了 Krishna， 为了 Krishna 而去做，所以如果真的是如此的话，必然会是感受到超然的喜乐的。
But if we're bringing our own bodily consciousness into the activities,then we won't experience the transcendental pleasure.
可是我们在做服务的时候，从事这些活动的时候，如果把我们的躯体概念带进这个活动的话，那么我们就感受不到这种超然的极乐。
Devotional service can also be performed, influenced by the mode of goodness, or passion, or ignorance.
我们在从事奉爱服务的时候，是有可能，就是遭受这个物质属性的激情属性或愚昧属性的影响打扰，就是也就是说，我们被这个属性所打扰。我们在从事奉爱服务的时候，那我们自己被这个属性所影响了，而以这样的属性来从事活动，因此感受不到那样的超然喜乐。
So remember, in performing devotional service, it's important for us to be attached to Krishna and detached from the results.
大家是否还记得我们说我们在从事奉爱服务的时候，我们要带着这种依恋 Krishna 的态度去从事，而要就是不执着于活动的结果。
If
we're, 我们要把所有的一切献给 Krishna， 然后不执着于活动的结果。
If we're looking to enjoy the result ourselves, then this is not bhakti yoga. This is,
可是如果
this is sakama karma yoga.
可是如果我们带着想要享受这个活动结果的心态来从事这个活动的话，那么我们不是在做奉爱服务，我们等于是处在 Sakama Karma Yoga 的层面，也就是带着物质欲望的这种活动瑜伽。
So it's very important for us to let go, not to hold on to the results and thinking that I'm the doer, but to let go and just simply hold on to Krishna, become attached to Krishna, that understand Krishna is the doer.
所以我们一定要学习放下，放下什么呢？我们要放下自己要享受这个结果的这种心态，就是要了解自己不是这个活动者，所以就要保持这种不执着的这种心态，那要紧紧地依附着 Krishna， 就是依恋着 Krishna， 知道 Krishna 是所有的一切的这种控制者，他才是那个执行者，他才是真正的活动者。
We don't want to give up the work, but we want to give up the attachment to the result of the work.
我们不是要大家放下这个活动，并不是大家不要活动，我们要放下的，要弃绝的是这种执着的心态，我们应该要放下那种想要享受活动结果的那种心态。
Remember, Arjuna has some confusion with Krishna's instructions. He thought Krishna was telling him to give up the work, but then Krishna is still encouraging him to fight. So Arjuna became confused.
大家是否还记得 Arjuna 其实就是对于 Krishna 给他的训示，他是感觉到这种困惑的。因为他以为就是 Krishna 所给他的教导，就是叫他不要去活动，是放下所有的活动。可是 Krishna 怎么还鼓励他去作战呢？所以他有困惑，为什么这是好像听起来就是自相矛盾的。
Krishna was speaking aboutrenunciation, detachment, and Arjuna thought that meant to stop, to give up work. But Krishna meant, no, don't give up the work, just give up your attachment to the result.
Krishna 提到的这个弃绝的这个字眼， Arjuna 立刻就以为他的意思是叫他不要活动，不要去打仗。但是事实上 Krishna 教导的不是这样。Krishna 的教导是要他放下想要执着于这个活动的结果的这种心态，并不是要他放下活动，并没有叫他不活动。 Krishna 要他活动，但是不要执着于活动的结果。
If you look at chapter 5 of the Bhagavad Gita, chapter 5 is titled Karma Yoga, Action in Krishna Consciousness.
如果我们看《薄伽梵歌原译》的第五章的标题是“活动瑜伽”，怀着 Krishna 知觉意识来活动。
Now, the actual title of the fifth chapter is Sanyas Yoga. So Lord Srila Prabhupada is giving what is the Krishna conscious interpretation of Sanyas Yoga.
那这第五章的梵文的标题是 Sanyas Yoga， 那 Srila Prabhupada 就以 Krishna 知觉意识的角度来解释什么叫做 Sanyas， 就是什么叫做弃绝。
So people think Sanyas means give up work, don't do anything, stop everything.
人们对于这个弃绝的概念以为是 放下所有的一切，什么都不做。
But the Krishna conscious understanding is stop everything which has nothing to do with Krishna, and just simply perform actions in relation to Krishna.
嗯，那事实上，以 Krishna 意识知觉的角度来了解的话，不活动，那么跟 Krishna 一点关系都没有。宁可是在从事活动，但是是跟 Krishna 建立这种关联，就是为 Krishna 而活动。
So this was very important for Arjuna, because Arjuna was thinking to give up the battle, not to fight.
那这件事情，这个概念对 Arjuna 是极为重要的，因为 Arjuna 他本来还在想，就是不想去参战，不想活动。
But Krishna wants him to fight. But Krishna wants him to fight for him. He wants him to do it out of devotion, working devotion for the pleasure of Krishna.
可是事实上 ，Krishna 是要 Arjuna 去参战的，去打这场战，而是为他而打，为他而战，为了取悦 Krishna 而去做。而去参与这场战争，就是 Krishna 真。
Why does Krishna？
为什么呢
？Why does Krishna want Arjuna to fight？ Krishna simply wants Arjuna to become detached from the result of the work and to take shelter of Lord Krishna, to be an instrument in the service of Krishna。
为什么 Krishna 还是要 Arjuna 去打这场战争呢？就是那为什么就是让 Arjuna 就是能够保持着这种不执着的气绝的心态，那然后去参与这场战争，他只是成为Krishna 手中的工具去战斗。
We know in the 11th chapter, Lord Krishna will tell Arjuna.Just become an instrument in my service.
在第十一章中，Krishna 告诉 Arjuna， 你只是成为我的服务中的一个工具，我的就是你只是成为我的工具，我手中的工具，去参与这场战争。
Okay.
你是我战斗中的一个工具。
So this is the idea that our happiness is in serving Krishna. Our happiness is not in the success or the results, but it's simply doing service for Krishna. That is happiness.
我们真正的快乐是去服务 Krishna, 去取悦 Krishna, 而不是说不活动，或者是说去渴望想要去得到活动的结果，不是，而是去服务 Krishna。
And when we try to please Krishna, the result is we become pleased.
而当我们为 Krishna 做服务的时候，真正我们真正渴望的这种结果就会自动到来。
Thank you very much.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. 还有Shruti Rupa Mataji 有问题，还有 Charu Chitra Mataji 有问题，那是不是就直接帮他们打开麦克风？
聊天快捷问题。
我能打开。
好的，那是谁先
？Hare Krishna. 我的说话可以听见了吗？
一个一个来哦，一个一个来啊，听得见啊。
Hare Krishna，
Hare Krishna，
敬拜所有的奉献者老师、翻译老师 ，Hare Krishna。是这样，今天想要请教 Guru 的一个问题呢，是我现在生活当中可能说来话有点长，那么就用说的方式。是这样的，就在我身边呢，陆陆续续又发生了几起，身体都比较平常身体很好，一检查癌症晚期。那么就是比较熟悉的人呢，他们可能现在对我，就是我现在这种状态呢，他们就会发出一些邀请吧，就是希望我来给他们祈祷呀，因为他们也不知道我做什么。那么也就是说我的生活已经很真实的在涉及临终关怀的这一块儿， 我今天就是想请教咕噜，对于就是不同知觉层面，比如说啊，有一些他开始刚刚接触风爱的，那有一些还没有接触风爱的，或者已经在比较深入长时间在学习风爱的这些不同的啊这些人群的家属或者他们本人，遇到这种临终关怀的时候，咕噜有什么样的训示，或者是说我们针对不同的人有没有一些可以我们慢慢把它形成一个规范的，比如说走到家庭怎么跟家属去啊沟通，要约定一些什么样的规则，对这个到家庭当中以后对亡者我们应该做什么样的一些流程，把它有没有这种可以值得借鉴的这种临终关怀的一套程序。 Hare Krishna， 这是我的问题，谢谢。
Hare KrishnaMaharaj, this is from Shruti Rupa Mataji. She would like to get your guidance about how to take care of different levels of devotees, because there are a few, some people, she cultivates some people around her, and you know, they look well, but somehow just,when they get a physical checkup, they find out that they suffer from terminal cancer. So she tried to pray for them and show her concern and affection, but she would like to know how to take care of different levels of devotees according to their situation.How to help them, especially for those who suffer from the terrible disease and may die anytime.
Well, I think we're all in that position that we may die anytime. Not just those who have terminal diseases. We all have a material body and we could all die anytime.
那其实我们每一个人都是血肉之躯，所以事实上我们的物质身体不是只有在癌末的人才可能面临死亡，其实我们每个人随时都有可能面临死亡的。
So the person who's already been identified as having some terminal disease, they should consider themselves fortunateThat they've been given a warning that they have to prepare to leave the body.
那对于你身边那些就是所谓的临终的这些癌症的癌末的病人，其实他们也算是幸运的，因为他们还被通告说，他是患了这样的绝症，他还能够有所准备，所以他还算幸运的。
So you should give them instructions in how to prepare for leaving the body.
所以你可以给他们一些引导指示，就是如何去做好这个准备，就是准备离开身体的一些准备。
Srimad Bhagavatam is all about preparation for death.
圣典国家瓦坛就是给了我们很多很多的训示引导，关于要怎么样去准备好面对这个死亡。
And if people are not eager to hear about preparing for death, if they consider this to be something they want to think about later on in life, they think, well, I'll wait till I get older, then these people are foolish.
那有些人呢，他们很愚蠢，他们其实不太想去听什么做为死亡做准备的这一类的事情，他们觉得那是年老以后才应该要去思维的，才去准备的，这跟他没什么相干。那像这样的人是很愚蠢的，无知的。
We have to convince them of the nature of the material body.And we have to get them to understand that it takes time for us to prepare ourselves to leave the body and to detach ourselves from this world.
那我们必须要去绝对的相信，去说服这些身边的人，让他们了解所谓的物质身体的本质。那也要让他们知道，去了解物质的身体的状况是怎么一回事。所以事实上要准备好面对死亡是需要时间的，必须花时间去做一些准备，让自己能够保持在一种不执着的这种心态来面对最后的一考。
So you have to investigate how much a person is materially attached. A person who is very materially attached, they're going to have great difficulty to study Krishna consciousness.
所以我们要去帮助人，我们首先要了解对方，我们要先去做一些了解，一些调查，了解对方他现在是到底处在多么执着的状况，他对物质的这种执着有多深，我们才能够知道怎么对症下药。
So there's a great need for education. People all need this education. They need to be educated about the nature of the soul and the nature of the material body and this material world.
所以重要的是要给予人们灵性的教育。如果我们能够让人们了解灵魂，了解物质身体，了解这个物质世界的这种本性本质的话，给他们这样的教育，肯定就能够帮助他们。
So you're doing this work, you're preaching to these people. This very important work. You have to educate them.About the nature of the body and the soul.
所以你现在正在向这些人，你身边的这些人，向他们传播 Krishna 知觉。那么很重要的就是你自己必须配备这些灵性的知识，然后把这个恰当的知识给予这些人，教他们关于灵魂以及物质的这方面的知识。
In Srimad Bhagavatam, it tells about one great king called Maharaj Gatvanga.Maharaj Gatvanga had went to fight on behalf of the demigods against the demons, and he gave a lot of pleasure to the demigods. He fought very well, so the demigods were very pleased with him, and they gave him a benediction.
His name is Gatvanga.
Gatvanga.
Gatvanga. 在圣殿不教瓦坛有一个。叫做Kabanga is a king.
Yes.
是一个国王Kabanga国王，那他就是代表半神人去打击这些恶魔。那因为他作战能力武艺高强，所以他非常的取悦半神人，于是半神人就给他祝福。
So he asked them, he said, just tell me, how long have I got left in this material world?
国王就是问这个半神人，就说他在这个物质世界还能够活多久。
So the demigods told them, you have only one moment of time left.
他说你只剩下一刻的时间可以存活。
Immediately the king came down from the heavenly planets, he came back to the earth planet.And he immediately gave up his body when he came here.
他听到这样，他二话不说，立刻就从天堂星球下来，就是到地球上，立刻放弃他的物质身体。
He came here and he sat and fixed his mind on the lotus feet of the Lord, and immediately gave up his body.
Kabanga 国王立刻就从天堂星球。回到这个地球上，立刻把他所有的专注力，就是专注全神贯注于主的莲花足上。
So this king only had one moment of time to prepare.
而这个国王他只有剩下一刻的时间，瞬间可以准备好自己面对死亡。
But for him, it was not difficult.Because he had already practiced detachment throughout his life.
可是对他来讲一点都不困难，因为他的一生 都在练习这种弃绝的心态，不执着的心态。
If you have not cultivated detachment, then we have to start doing it before we get too old, because at the end of life, we have to be detached.
如果我们还没有这样的不执着的这种心态的话，那么我们也要现在就立刻要开始，因为这个太重要了。因为早早晚晚我们都必须要面对要放下这个身体，所以我们不能等到那个时候才开始，我们必须要养兵千日用兵一时，我们现在就必须要开始练习这种不执着的心态。
In the Vedic system, life is divided into different ashrams. So first there is the student life, then there is the family lifeAnd then there is the retired life.
根据伟达的这个系统呢，灵性呢分为四个阶段。刚开始的时候是所谓的学生阶段，再来是居士阶段，再来是退出家庭生活的阶段。
The retired life is necessary to help us to prepare for the next life.
这种退出家庭的生活的这种阶段呢，是对于我们来说要准备好面对下一生来世是一个非常重要的一个准备阶段。
We have to understand it takes some time for us to get detached from the material world.
所以我们自己要有心理准备，我们要退出，就是这个物质存在。我们要能够对这个注意一下，请主持人拜托帮忙一下，把它的关闭一下。
So this is true for everyone.
Sorry, Maharaj, I haven't translated because this disturbance. 所以Maharaj 说，就是说我们要有心理准备。事实上，我们要能够对这个物质世界能够不执着的话。这个是需要时间去做准备的，我们不可能就是瞬间一夜之间就变得不执着了。
So we all have to leave this world, whether we know we've got cancer or not. We all know we're going to die. Every one of us, we take birth. One day we have to die, and we have to prepare for that.
所以我们每个人早早晚晚都要面临死亡的这个功课，不是只有。那些所谓的就是癌症末期的人才必须要面临，我们任何一个时刻任何人都有可能面临这个死亡，所以我们要有所准备，准备好这种弃绝的心态。
Are you ready, Shruti Rupa? 你准备好了吗？
所以 Mataji Maharaj 在问你，他说你准备好了吗？没有听到他的声音呢。
Okay.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Gurudev.
Hare Krishna.
然后有咕噜的祝福，我会从现在开始做准备。还有最后一个问题，因为今天是世俗层面的父亲节，我的父亲离开这个世界20年了，想请教咕噜，就是我现在的这种灵性学习，对父亲的灵魂有帮助吗？还有就是，我们作为您的灵性孩子，因为我是一个初级的学生，那么您对我们。如何取悦你？有什么样的训示吗 ？Hare Krishna, 感恩 Guru Dev。
你的问题那么多。Okay, so yes, you're doing the greatest service for your father by being a devotee. Your father will get benefit. You become a good, pure devotee. Your father will get great benefit.
是的，你成为一个奉献者，对你的父亲肯定有帮助的。如果你能够成为一个纯粹的奉献者的话，那么对你父亲的帮助就会非常的巨大。
And you want to please, you want to please me? You want to know how you can please me? You just keep on preaching Krishna consciousness and trying to distribute books and tell people about Krishna. Very good.
那你如果在这个父亲节你想要取悦我的话，你就好好的做传播 Krishna 知觉的这个就活动吧，好好派书，好好把 Krishna 给予人们吧。这就是取悦 Maharaj 的方法。
OK， 我们听 Charu Chitra Mata 这个问题。
好的，接下来我们Charu Chitra Mata 这个。
好的 ，Krishna， 明白。Guru Day， 明白。Samashinari， Mata 姐，明白。房间里所有的奉献者，谢谢 Guru 的讲课。然后我在听到第四章的十七十节的时候，Krishna 告诉我们说，人应该正确去认识这个三种活动，一个就是什么是活动，什么是被禁止的活动，第三个是什么是不活动。我的理解是这样的，就是什么是活动，就是在 Krishna 知觉当中去行事做事就是活动，被禁止的活动就是经典当中不允许做的事儿，就是被禁止的活动。那什么是不活动呢？就是实际上这个现象，我觉得好像应该是不存在的，就是不活动，就是一个人他什么也没做，但是他内心的这个意识还在想事儿，还是内在还在活动。那如果我们带着Krishna知觉去活动，把这个结果这个交给Krishna，就相当于我们就是不活动，因为我们的活动，这样的活动不带来任何报应，所以把它理解成不活动。我这样理解对吗？Hare Krishna，谢谢你，Guru Dev。
Hare Krishna, Maharaj.
Yeah.
Maharaj, do you understand? Do I have to translate for
yeah,
you?
Yeah, pretty much.
Because she just gave the comments.And also, she tried to explain
action and inaction
in the text 17, chapter 17. You mentioned these three items of in your lecture.
Yeah.
And she want to confirm if her understanding is correct.
Yeah.
So, do you think I have to translate or not?
No, it's okay. Yes. Okay. Yes. A devotee's activities, we could say they're described as inaction, because there's no reaction coming from the activities of a devotee. Devotee's activities are not of the material world, they're transcendental.
奉献者的所从事的活动不是物质性的活动，是超然的活动。因此它不会带来任何的业报反应，所以我们说它是不活动。
And what, so a devotee's activities are all in action. In actions, it's like they're not doing any activities because there's no reactions.
那奉献者虽然从事活动，但是因为他不会得到，他的所从事的活动不会造致任何的业力的反应，所以就是叫做不活动，因为它不会招致这个业报。
And the impersonalist or the gyanis, they're trying to stop activities, but they cannot stop activities because the nature of the soul is to be always active.
那些gyani呢？那他们想要试图去停止活动，但是根本就做不了。因为我们灵性的灵魂的本质注定了一定要活动。
So they're doing karma. They're doing karmic activities. They get some reaction.
所以他们就是等于是他们所从事的活动一定会招致所谓的这个业力的反应，一定会招致业报，就是果报性的活动。
But the devotees, their actions are all akarma. Akarma means no reaction.
可是奉献者所从事的活动是 akarma， 意思就是说没有业力的，没有报应的。
But your understanding about prohibited action, acts against the scriptures, that's correct.
你对于这个被禁止的活动的理解是对的，就是是被禁止的，经典违反经典的教导的这种活动。
Yeah. All right. You understand, Chari Chitra?
Yes, yes.Yes, yes, yes, I understand. Thank you. Thank you, Guru Maharaj. Now I'm fully and very clear.
All right.
好，那我们现在聊天室有一些问题，我们来看一下。Janaka, Prabhu 发送的一个海云问，请问Guru Dev, 不是纯粹的奉爱服务也会产生业报反应吗？The question is that, impure devotional service, does impure devotional service cause, you know, a reaction, cause karmic reaction?
No, pure devotional service.
Impure devotional service, mixed.
Not
mixed devotional service.
Mixed devotional service, yes. There will be reactions.
对，不纯粹的这个奉爱服务会产生业报反应的。
Yeah, must be.
一定会的，会有这个 fruitive reaction.
In proportion.
会有这个业报反应。
Depending on how impure the devotional service is, there will be reactions.
根据这个不纯粹度有多么不纯粹，就会产生相应的业报反应。上面的这个问题this question is from Vedavati Mataji. Maharaj, can we go on to the next question?
Yeah.
Hare Krishna, 禀拜 Guru 和翻译。祝灵性父亲父亲节快乐，愿您身体健康平安快乐。我的问题是，有的时候为了刻意避免自己的躯体化概念和依附，故意抛开体式瑜伽，只念诵 Hare Krishna， 可是自己现在念诵还不够专注，导致生活和工作的效率低下，然后练习了体式瑜伽后效率就提升了，我就处于了矛盾中，请咕噜给予指导，感恩。First, his obeisances to Maharaj, and you know, happy Father's Day, and praying that you are in good health.
Okay.
My question is that sometimes, in order to prevent from my own bodily conception and attachment, so I purposely give up my yoga practice, physical asana practice, just chant Hare Krishna. But since my chanting is not attentive, so my work, you know, become not efficient.My life become not efficient. So this is why I resume my yoga practice. And this way, suddenly the efficiency was increased. So I was in such kind of, you know, contradiction. So I would like, you know, Guru Maharaj to give me some guidance. Thank you very much.
Well, it's important for you to have some activity, to have some engagement, to keep yourself busy. If you're not accustomed to keeping yourself engaged in hearing and chanting, then it will be difficult for you to suddenly take it up, because you were used to teaching and having work and doing jobs, and then to suddenly stop and not have work anymore, then it's difficult for you to take up full time just hearing and chanting.
对，如果你现在还没有办法达到就是纯粹只是聆听跟念诵，那么你应该让自己有所从事，也就是说你必须让自己 保持着忙碌的状态，让你的心意有所从事，这样的话，才不会让自己突然就是生活好像处在这种宕机的状态，好像就是就有点走不动了，因为就是你需要从事活动，所以你可以让自己就是除了念诵跟聆听之外，还要加入就是其他的，就像你说的这个你自己的体位法什么的。
So I think it's good you're back teaching yoga, you're back there in your work. I think that's good for you, keep yourself active. And at the same time, you can introduce bhakti yoga to people.
所以你想你现在在回到就是去练习瑜伽教导瑜伽传扬 Krishna 知觉给其他人的状态中，这种活跃的状态是好的，这样对你反而是好的。
OK、yeah.
这样可以吗、好，那下一个是 Mantosh Kumar Prabhu Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj Jai、wish all of your good health. And Maharaj, did you see what he say? I can translate directly and you can...
Where is it? In the chat?
Wish all of your good health.And safety. My question is how to balance karma, vikarma, and akarma in our daily nowadays life in this age of Kali, Haribol.
Well,
这个 Mantosh Prabhu 的意思是在问说，就是说怎么样能够在活动以及就是被禁止的活动以及不活动中。在当今的年代，卡利年代，保持一种平衡。
I would advise you to eliminate all vikarmic activities.
我的建议是你就是放下所有被禁止的活动。
Right, that means meat, fish and eggs, intoxication, gambling, illicit connection with the other sex. All these things have to be stopped completely.
也就是说完全遵守我们现在所推行的这个规范的守则这个戒律我们不去吃鱼肉蛋不去吸食麻醉自我的这些东西我们不从事那些非法的性行为也不赌博这些
Now,
所以这些都是被禁止的活动
Karma activities means activities which should be according to scripture which are performed for our own material benefit.
Karma 指的就是根据的，根据经典去从事能够得到物质收益、物质获益的那种活动叫 karma。
So you definitely want to minimize these kinds of activities.
那这类的活动尽量把它减低。
You want to increase your activities of akarma, means acts of devotional service.
然后增加你的 akarma 这个部分，也就是增加你的奉爱服务。
You want to do more hearing and chanting, especially.
特别是增加你的聆听以及对圣灵的吟诵。
And you want to connect your work to the service of Krishna. Do it for Krishna. Do it in Krishna consciousness. We don't say stop work.But we say dovetail or connect your work to the service of Krishna.
而且就是尽量的让你的工作跟 Krishna 连接起来，不是说不活动，不是说不工作，而是让自己的活动能够就是为 Krishna 而工作，就是跟 Krishna 连接起来。
Okay, is there another question?
Okay, yeah.Another question is from Mathura Lila. Madhaji, Hare Krishna, 顶拜 Guru 和所有的奉献者，请问 Guru, 我在做一些服务的时候总是想要做到最好，会给自己很多压力，要怎么能做到不依附结果，放弃对结果的执着，把结果交给 Krishna 呢？ Maharaj, do you understand?
Yes.
Madhaji say, oh, you understand, okay.
Yes. It's nice that you want to do good for Krishna, but you have to remember you're simply the instrument in the service of Krishna.
你希望能够为 Krishna 做服务，做到尽善尽美，当然是好事。但是你不要忘记了，你只是 Krishna 手中的一个工具而已。
The results are given by Krishna.
结果是 Krishna 决定的，赐予的。
If we get a good result, you give the credit to Guru and Krishna.
如果你做这件事服务得到的是好的结果，你也应该把这个结果啊。就是献给 Guru, 献给 Krishna.
And if the results are no good, you have to take the blame.
可是这个结果如果活动的这个服务的结果不好的话，你应该要就是知道是自己做的不好。
Just like
you shouldn't put the blame on yourself or put the blame on yourself.
Yeah, you should take the blame. You take the blame yourself.
你自己要承担这个不好的结果。
Just like there was this one Prabhupada's godbrother, he was a brahmachari, he was an elderly man, and he would cook for the devotees, and he would cook very nice. So all the devotees would praise him that, oh, your cooking is so good.
就像是的 Prabhupada, 他有一个神兄弟，他是一个 brahmachari, 那他就为奉献者做这个做饭，然后做得很好，那奉献者就赞美他，哇，你真的做饭做得真好。
So he would say, if it tastes good, thank Krishna. And if it's not good, then you blame me.
他就说如果你们觉得我做的 prasada 很好吃的话，你们就感谢 Krishna 吧。可是如果我做的不好吃，你们就怪我吧。
One time the devotees, they did a big program in India here, in New Delhi, and they had it was very successful, and many people came. So after the program, they all met together with with Prabhupada, and they met together, and one devotee was saying, oh, we really did it, we did so good, it was such a great program. And Prabhupada looked at him and said, we didn't do anything.Krishna did it.
那有一次奉献者在印度那个新德里办了一个非常的浩大的一个活动，那活动非常非常的成功，然后奉献者们就是欢天喜地的聚在一起讨论，然后Srila Prabhupada也在场，那奉献者们就讲说，你看我们这次的活动办得多么的成功啊，然后Srila Prabhupada就说，不，我们什么都没有做，我们什么都没有做，是 Krishna 做的，我们什么都没有做。
Another time, the devotees were invited to this very rich man's house to have a program. So Prabhupada was there, and Prabhupada told the one devotee, he said, you should ask the man to buy a set of my books.
有一次奉献者就被邀请到一个有钱人家去那办活动，那奉献Srila Prabhupada就告诉奉献者说你应该叫这个有钱人来买一套我的书。
So the devotee stood up and he gave a speech to the man about Prabhupada's books, and he told him how these books were distributed all over the world and they were appreciated by scholars.But the man said, oh no, I've got enough books, I don't need these books.
那这个奉献者就起身走向这个有钱人家的这个主人跟他说这个书呢是如何的在这个世界各地派发是多么好，那是多么的受到欢迎，多么重要的书，那也受到了一些就是学者的一些欣赏。所以你应该要买这个书，去了包括他的书非常好。那但是这个有钱人说，哦，不用了，不用了，我已经有太多太多的书了，我不要。
So after the program, the devotee came to Prabhupada. He said, Prabhupada, I'm sorry. Did I say something wrong about your books? But Prabhupada said, no. He said, what you said was all right. But Prabhupada said, one who knows the value of my books, they will purchase.
那这个人就这个奉献者后来就是来到Srila Prabhupada跟他说，这个人没有买你的书，那是不是我有什么这个过程跟他交涉的过程中有做错什么讲错什么吗？说错了什么？Srila Prabhupada说，哦，没有没有，你没有说错什么，没有做错什么。一旦他们了解了这个书之后他们就会买的。
And so, you know, Prabhupada was detached. He understood sometimes we'll be successful, sometimes not.
Srila Prabhupada 就是在说，事实上，有些时候我们所做的服务会成功，有些时候并没有办法成功。
Krishna is pleased by the effort, by when we make an effort.
而取悦 Krishna 的是我们的态度，我们的努力，这是真正取悦 Krishna 的关键。
And just like in Prabhupada's time, the devotees went to Japan to distribute books. So the devotees would distribute books, and sometimes a devotee would get in trouble, they'd be arrested and they'd be sent back because they were selling the books in the street, and the Japanese, they didn't like the devotees collecting money so much in the street.
就像在Srila Prabhupada那个时候那个年代，有些奉献者他们在日本派发书籍，他们上街头，那有些时候他们也甚至于会被警察逮捕，因为警察也他们也有些人不喜欢他们在街上这样派书然后就是募款这样子。
So it came in the newspaper, Hare Krishna devotee deported from Japan.So Prabhupada's godbrother, one of the godbrothers, he said, look at this, this is not good. Your men are going to Japan, they got deported.
那就是Srila Prabhupada的神兄弟就看到了这则日本的奉献者的这个街头的派书的事情的报道，然后他就说，你看这个报道真的不是很正面说你的这个奉献者呢在街头所做的这些事情就讲的是很有点负面的这种报道。
But Prabhupada said to him, he said, at least we went there. You didn't even go there.
但是Srila Prabhupada看到的是另外一面他看到了说至少这些奉献者们他们到了日本那你不需要再去就是他们上了去了日本。
No, I think you didn't get it right, Shama Sundar.
So what? So, sorry, Maharaj, what do you mean?
I said that Prabhupada was pleased that the devotees had gone there, even though they got deported. But Prabhupada said his godbrothers, they never even made the attempt to go there.
Srila Prabhupada, 的想法是至少这些奉献者他们已经去了那里尽管有那样的报道。So Maharaj, you say attempted what Srila Prabhupada's god brother?
They did not go. They didn't even try to go there.
Oh, I see. They didn't attempt to. I see. 那这些他的神兄弟至少他们还没有这么做。没有去那里至少这些奉献者他们已经努力的去做了，而他的Srila Prabhupada的神兄弟他并没有去做这件事情。
So you know, the Prabhupada could have criticized, yeah, my devotees, they're silly, they don't know how to behave properly, they get arrested. But Prabhupada defended them, that they tried to do something for Krishna.
那所以Srila Prabhupada 他也可以因为他的门徒这件事情来批评他的门徒，但是他并没有这么做，他并没有因为他的门徒在日本然后还被逮捕这件事情来批评他们，他反而是看到了他们的用心，他们的努力，他们去为 Krishna 做了这件事情。
Just like Lord Nityananda tried to make Jagai and Madhai into devotees, but the first time he failed.They had to run away. Haridas Thakur and Lord Nityananda had to run to save themselves because they got chased by Jagai and Madhai.
就像当时尼贾南达·帕布跟哈里达斯·塔库，他们也是要去就是传扬主的荣耀，派发圣灵。可是那个他们遇到扎盖跟马代的时候，他们也是刚开始的时候也是失败了，他们还落荒而逃，因为这个扎盖跟马代还追赶他们，要伤害他们。
But they did not give up. They came back again and preached to them, tried to get them to chant.
但是他们并没有因此就放弃了，他们还一再的回到那个地方去就是去教化这个扎盖跟马代。
And so we should not be discouraged when we fail in our attempts to spread Krishna consciousness.
所以当我们在为 Krishna 做服务的时候，在传扬 Krishna 知觉意识的时候，我们如果遇到了不好的事情、挫折或者失败了，我们也千万不要沮丧。
We should think failure is a pillar of success.
我们要知道失败就是成功之母。
So we have to be patient and we have to keep endeavoring.
所以我们要保持相当的耐心，继续的努力。
Prabhupada endeavored for many years before he got success.
是的，帕布帕在他达到成功之前，他真的用了很多很多年的时间，努力的去执行这些这些训示。
All right, any other questions?
No.
We've finished all
no other questions.
All the questions in the chat, finished?
Finished.
Okay, very good. Thank you very much, Shamsundari Mataji. Very kind of you to translate. Thank all the devotees for listening and for the questions. May you all keep safe and healthy.
很感谢所有的奉献者的参与还有提问，也感谢双方圣教育的翻译那希望大家都能够把自己照顾好，然后保持让自己就是平安健康。
Srila Prabhupada.
Thank you, Maharaj. Thank you, Maharaj, for the class today.
Okay, thank you for giving me the chance.
Thank you, Maharaj.
Thank you.
很感谢Mukundanagar Prabhu的邀请，给了这个机会Maharaj来讲课。
Okay, Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai.
Jai.
His holiness Bhakti Vijayana Maharaj Ki Jai.
Gaur Bhakti Vrinda Ki.